I get to hear all sorts way up here on the roof of Westminster Abbey. Angelic voices from the choir, priests' prayers offered up to the heavens, the respectful chattering of visitors, whether they be worshippers, tourists from around the world, schoolchildren taking a tour, or even kings and queens. That's the amazing thing about this place. All are welcome, be they high or low, rich or poor, good or, well, not so good. I listen and learn from them all. I may be an old stone head, but you can claim I'm the wisest corbel at the Abbey. In fact, it's the stonemasons who have always interested me the most. They're always up here making, repairing, replacing. I'll never forget them discussing this thing. Now, I know it looks like a bit of grey stone, but from what I heard, I can't help but think this is a little comment from King Edward the Confessor himself. Now, Edward was the king who wanted an abbey built here almost 1,000 years ago. He busied himself with all the details, including this thing, a column capital. It used to sit on top of one of the many columns that hold this amazing building up, and this one used to live outside, which explains why the features look so worn. What can you see? There's a lot of pointing, a building, and a woman carrying what looks like a baby. There's also someone on their knees who look like they're praying or begging for something. And then there's someone wearing a crown. Listening to the builders, I happen to know this is King Solomon from the Bible. But that said, perhaps you'd be forgiven for thinking this could also be Edward. You see, kings and queens like people to think they're great. It's all part of being a good ruler, and Edward was no different. It made sense for him to fill his new abbey with pictures and stories about really great rulers from the Bible, and King Solomon is often thought of as the wisest of all. But what exactly is happening in this image? Well, this story is all about the judgment of King Solomon. The story goes that two women came to the king. One of the women carried a baby, but both the women claimed to be the mother. Could the king decide which woman would get to keep and care for the baby? The people waited in silence as Solomon thought for a while, and then he spoke. "Bring me my sword." There was a gasp. What was he going to do? Wielding the blade in his hands, the king declared the only solution would be to cut the child in two and give each woman half to take home. At this judgment, the first woman praised Solomon's wisdom. "Of course," she said. "If the real mother can't take the baby home, then neither of us should." The second woman pleaded with the king. "Please," she begged, "don't kill the baby. At least give it to the other woman so it may live." And with that, Solomon made his true judgment. Only a true mother would give up her own child to save its life. The baby was handed to the second woman, and the first woman was led away to receive her punishment. I love this story, and I always wonder, if I was the king, would I have made such a clever decision? I trust those who rule over us will act wisely and for the good of us all. Maybe this is the message Edward wanted us to consider, just from this one tiny detail of the Abbey.